गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ कंप्यूटर आर्किटेक्चर एंड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट फर्स्ट थ्री एड्रेसिंग मोड। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द रिमेनिंग एड्रेसिंग मोड्स। सो इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन फर्स्ट थ्री एड्रेसिंग मोड, दैट इज इमीजिएट एड्रेसिंग मोड, रजिस्टर एड्रेसिंग मोड एंड डायरेक्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड। ओके, सो इन इमीजिएट एड्रेसिंग मोड डेटा और ऑपरेंड इज डायरेक्टली गिवन इन एन इंस्ट्रक्शन। इन रजिस्टर एड्रेसिंग मोड ऑपरेंड इज गिवन बाय रजिस्टर एंड इन डायरेक्टली डायरेक्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड वी डोंट हैव अ डेटा, ओनली एड्रेस ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर डेटा, एड्रेस ऑफ पर्टिकुलर मेमोरी लोकेशन विच होल्ड्स द डेटा इज गिवन इन एन इंस्ट्रक्शन, दैट इज डायरेक्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड। ओके, सो इन टूडेज लेक्चर वी विल सी द नेक्स्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड, दैट इज इनडायरेक्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड। ओके, सो व्हाट इज इनडायरेक्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड? Address is given by a register. As in direct addressing mode, address is directly given in an instruction like move BL, 2000. Address is directly given in an instruction. But in indirect addressing mode, address is given by a register. Okay. Address is given by a register. So what is that means? We are again giving an address, but this time address will be given by a register. So the data that I want to operate on, that data is stored somewhere in the memory. Its address is there somewhere inside a register. And I will tell the name of that register. I am telling the processor that go to that particular register. Let's say that register is BX. I am telling the processor that go to the BX. This BX will give the address. Then processor first go to BX. From there, it will get a number. Let's say from there, it will get a number 2000. That number is not a data. That number acts as an address. So processor will go to that address, from there it will get the data. Okay, let's say this is processor. Inside a processor there is a register BX. This is memory. Inside the memory there is an instruction that move CL, BX. Okay, now processor will fetch that instruction. After reading this instruction, processor get the name of register BX. Processor will go to the BX. BX holding some value, that is 2000. Now that time this 2000 is not a data. This 2000 is act as an address. So let's say somewhere in memory there is a location 2000. That location 2000 carries data 33. So after getting this value, processor will go to that memory location and reads the data 33, and after that it will execute this instruction that move CL, 33. So CL will get the data 33. Okay, so more than 95% operations in a computer are done by using this indirect addressing mode. Okay, now this indirect addressing mode is subdivided into four addressing modes. So first one is register indirect addressing mode, then register relative, third one is base indexed, and then base relative plus index. Okay, so we will discuss these all four types one by one. So first let's start with the register indirect addressing mode. Okay, so register indirect addressing mode, it means that address in register, address is not directly given in an instruction, address is in register. Okay, so let's say instruction move CL comma BX. Okay, it means that CL will get in square bracket BX. So move into CL the contents located at the address of BX. So BX is not a memory location, BX is a register location in a processor, because all registers are stored in a processor. So BX is a register location in a processor. So this is the processor, this is a memory. Within the processor, there is a register BX, and that BX register has a value. Normally that value is your data, but when you write BX in square bracket, it means that that value will be used as an address. So suppose this BX is 2000. Okay, so 2000 in this case, it is an address. We will be using it as an address. So if I write only BX, okay, so you are talking about only BX register. When you write BX inside a square bracket, then it acts as an address. Okay, so in this case you are using BX as a memory pointer, you are using BX as a register that gives the address of some memory location. Which address? Address 2000, which is somewhere in the memory. Okay, so what instruction is? Move CL comma BX. So CL will get the data from some memory location which is pointed by this BX register. Okay, so this is your processor, this is your memory, in which there is an instruction that move CL comma BX. Somewhere there is a location 2000, and in that location there is a data 33. So suppose your BX is 2000, BX could be any value. Okay, so first of all, processor will fetch this instruction. This instruction says move into CL. Okay, so it's okay, CL will get the value of BX, not exactly the BX, whatever inside BX will act as an address. So processor will go to that address, because BX hold 2000, so processor will go to that location 2000. From this it will get the data 33 and move it into CL. Okay, so this is the memory. It has a so let's say another example, this is a memory, it has a memory location 4000, which contains data 25. Okay, now this time move CL comma BX. Now in this case BX is 4000. Okay, because BX holding memory location 4000. Okay, so this time BX again will act as an address, and that address carries data 25, which processor transfer into CL. Okay, now let's say there is another memory location, that is 5000. Now this location 5000, it contains something. So whatever it contains, I want this data to come into CL. Okay, whatever this memory location 5000 contains, I want this data to come into register CL. This is, let's say this is another example. Okay, so question is that get me that data from memory location 5000 into register CL. So for doing this, there are two ways. First, यू कैन यूज इट यू कैन डू इट आइदर डायरेक्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड और इनडायरेक्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड. सो फर्स्ट डू इट यूजिंग डायरेक्ट एड्रेसिंग मोड. वॉट इज द क्वेश्चन? मूव CL, CL transfer such contents into CL which are located at location 5000. Okay, so first do it by using direct addressing mode. So how we will do it? Move CL comma 5000. Simply, address is given in an instruction, that is direct addressing mode. We want contents which is located at memory location 5000. So by using direct addressing mode, we can write it as move CL comma 5000. Okay, now let's do it by using indirect addressing mode. So what is indirect addressing? We are using register as a pointer. Okay, which register? Let's say register BX. So first of all, I need to do is initialize the BX with value 5000. Okay, first step is that we have to initialize register BX with the 5000. So move BX comma 5000. Okay, no square bracket for BX comma 5000. Okay, now in this case 5000 is act as a data for this BX. Okay, now I am going to use that as an address. Okay, now your BX is initialized. That means your BX is becoming 5000. Now I want to use it as an address by writing move CL comma BX. Now after giving square bracket, this 5000 is act as an address. Okay, now BX is pointer for that address. Okay, so for direct addressing mode, we are directly writing like this, move CL comma 5000. That means processor will directly get the contents from 5000. Now in indirect addressing mode, first we have to initialize register with 5000. Okay, so move BX comma 5000. Now your BX is becoming 5000, and after that we have to use that 5000 as an address. So write BX inside a square bracket. Now the value of this BX is act as an address. Okay, are you getting this point? That is, CL should get the data from a memory location whose address is given by BX. Since BX is 5000, CL will still get the data from 5000. Let's say it is 30. So what will be the value of CL? The value of CL will be 30. Okay. So direct addressing mode and indirect addressing mode, both eventually are doing the same thing. And direct addressing mode is more easier than the indirect addressing mode. Then why we use indirect addressing mode? There is a massive advantage of using indirect addressing mode that you cannot done using direct addressing mode. Okay, so get me the data from location 5000. Which addressing mode will you use? Direct addressing mode. Okay, in this way, get data from memory location 5000, you will use direct addressing mode because it is simple, it is easier than indirect addressing mode. Which addressing mode you are going to be use? Direct addressing mode. Okay, you got an answer. So why will you use indirect if you use direct? Why will you use indirect addressing mode if you can do it by using direct addressing mode? You have to write this instruction, move CL comma 5000. Hundred times. Okay, question is that get me the data from memory location 5000. Okay, Which addressing mode will you use? Direct addressing mode. Okay, but if question is that get, here you will use direct addressing mode. Okay, then another question is that get me the data from hundred number of memory location, not from the 100 address, 100 times of memory locations. Now which addressing mode you are going to use, direct or indirect? In this case you are going to use indirect addressing mode. Why will you use indirect addressing mode if you use direct addressing mode? Because in direct addressing mode you have to write this instruction mov CL comma 5000 100 times. I forget here to mention memory location 5000. From memory location 5000 you have to fetch 100 memory location, that is 5001, 5002, 5003, like this. Okay, so if you have to fetch data from memory location 5000 only, that time you can use direct addressing mode. But if you have to fetch memory location 100 times from 5000, that time you will go to use indirect addressing mode. Because in direct addressing mode you have to write this instruction 100 times and you don't want to do programming like this. You write it once and you put it in a loop. That loop will execute 100 times. That is called as programming. Will you achieve anything by looping? Okay, so mov CL comma 5000, this instruction you will get always a value from, by using this instruction you will always get a value from 5000. Okay, so it's the worst way of programming. So you wanted the same data, you do it like this. Okay, if you want data from only memory location 5000, you can use this instruction. Okay, then what's the advantage? Now the instruction is not saying get the data from 5000, instruction saying get the data from any location pointed by bx. All you need to do is increment bx. Okay, we have to fetch data from memory location bx up to 100 memory location. So in this case we just increment bx by put it into a loop. Okay, so first instruction gets the data from 5000, second instruction will get the data from 5001, 5002 and so on. So as many iterations you perform, you get the data from many memory locations. Okay, so register indirect addressing mode is used where if you want to access more than one memory locations, you used which addressing mode? Direct. Okay, because it is simplest. But if you want to access series of locations, you will use indirect addressing mode because this is the way of doing it. Okay, now you tell me you have used a computer from the last 10 years. Okay, so how many times in your lifetime you access one location? Do you ever access only one location? One location carries one byte and one byte has no value in modern world. Okay, one byte is a very small quantity. We always access file, we always access everything you access is a file, and file is a kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, nowadays it is zettabyte. That is every time you are accessing a series of locations. So every activity by a computer is done by using which addressing mode? Indirect addressing mode. So right now you are watching a video. This video is brought to you by a server. What do you mean are? Your phone getting one byte from a server? No. One byte even not shows a dot on your screen. Every time chunks of data is stored in a memory and displayed. Okay, and chunk of data is stored in one location? No, it is stored in a series of locations. Okay, so all operations are done by indirect addressing mode. Other modes are also used, like immediate mode. When you want to initialize, you use immediate mode. How many times you initialize? You initialize only once, called initialization. Next, register addressing mode. During program, sometime you need to move value from one register to another register. That time you used register addressing mode. Then direct addressing mode. When you want to pick up just value from memory, for example your current system time, that time you use register addressing mode. As I told you, if you want to access only single data or same data from given memory location, that time you use direct addressing mode. Example is current system date and time. Okay, but for the series of data, you used indirect addressing mode. For example, C program. Okay, now let's say an array of 5 element, that is from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so if I write x is equals to a of 2 as an example, so it get the value of element number 2. Okay, so if I write x is equals to a of I. Okay, now I get the value of element. So for that, first I have to initialize I. Okay, so how will I initialize I? Let's say I is equals to 0. So I get the value of element number 0. Now what's the difference writing 0 over here? X is equals to a of 0 and I is equals to 0. Now this is indirect addressing mode. This is direct addressing mode. So now here I can put a loop and I can work on a whole array. So but to first do it, I have to initialize I, that is I equals to 0. Similarly, move bx comma 5000. Here I am initializing a register bx, and after that move cl comma bx. Now here I am using this bx as a pointer register, like this. Okay, so for example, in this case bx is a data and we are using that data as an address here. Okay, now match it with above example. This is about the register indirect addressing mode. Now next one is register relative addressing mode. Now in register address indirect addressing mode, address is given inside a register. Now in register relative indirect addressing mode, address is given as register plus displacement. Okay, so in register addressing mode, address is simply given by a register. Now here address is given by a register plus displacement. Okay, so let's say an instruction move cl comma bx plus 03h. okay, if you consider only this instruction, that means it is register indirect addressing mode. Okay, but plus 03h, that is displacement, it means that it is register relative addressing mode. Okay, it means that CL will get data from BX03H. okay, memory. Now let's say memory location 2000. This is memory. Now let's say memory location 2000. There is an array starting from 2000. Now I want data from 2003. Now this memory starts from memory location 2000, then 2001, 2002 and 2003. And I want the data from memory location 2003. So I can do it by using register indirect addressing mode. Okay, if I want data from memory location 2000 only, I can do it by using register indirect mode. Also, how for that, first I have to change BX. Okay, I have to increment BX or I have to increment address by 3. So, from this instruction, you will get the data from 2003 by using register indirect mode. You will directly get the data from memory location 2000 only. But if I want data from memory location 2003, I want to increment BX. Okay. So, now I have got my data, but I have lost my pointer. What happened if I increment BX? I increment BX by 1, then 2001. After that, I increment BX. Let's say, move CL, comma, BX, and your BX is 2000. To get data from 2003, I will increment BX. Then it will go to the 1. Again, I will increment BX. It will go to the 2002. Again, I will increment the BX, then it will go to the 2003. Okay, but here what I am doing? I am changing the contents of BX. Initially, BX was 2000, but right now BX is 2003. It means that what happened? I lost my pointer BX. Now, BX is no longer pointing to 2002. Okay, it got lost somewhere in the array. Now it is pointing to 2003. Now I want my BX back to my pointer. That is my original location. That is 2000. That means again I have to decrement BX. Then again I have to increment BX up to 2000. Okay. Do you understand? It takes more time of getting data. I don't want to waste my time around the memory. I want directly to point to the memory location 2003 by using relative addressing mode. Okay, so you can smoothly access the data from memory location related to the register. Okay, and in this case BX is still 2000, but we have to manage to get the data from 2003 without even changing the BX. So such type of instruction reduce your programming steps. Okay, so in this case, I can use BX as a reference position. I am not incrementing or decrementing BX here. I am using BX as a reference position. And I can access the data from any other location related by the pointer just by using displacement like 0, 3. It means that your BX is 2000. And this displacement 03, it means that 2003. So by using this instruction, you will directly get the data from 2003 in a single step. No more steps are required like incrementing and decrementing. Okay, so this is about register relative. That means address is given as register plus displacement. Okay, then another addressing mode, that is base index. Now here address is given as base register plus index register. Okay, let's say move CL comma BX plus SI. So this SI is a source index. This is an extra register provided by 8086 microprocessor. So CL BX plus SI. Okay, so CL get the data from memory location pointed by BX plus SI. So there is an array started from 2000 and there is an array of 100 locations from this 2000. Okay, and you want data from memory location 2020, then you want data from 2040, then you want data from 2060. You can do all this by using register relative, the previous addressing mode, just by doing bx plus 20, bx plus 40, bx plus 60. You can directly access the data from memory location 2020, 2040, 2060. Okay. But now you want data, patch of data from memory location 20 to 40. That means you want group of data, that is 2020, 2021, 2022 up to 2040. If you want this group of data, that time you have to use base indexed addressing mode. Okay, so if you use register relative again, you are on the same track, that bx plus 20, then increment bx plus 21, bx plus 22, bx plus 23 up to bx plus 40. Okay, again it requires number of instruction and it is wastage of time. So in this case we can use base indexed addressing mode. Okay, so keep bx as 2000, take another register like SI, initialize it with value 20 because we want data from 2020 to 2040. So initialize this source index register with 20, that means it becomes, so bx plus SI, so your bx is 2000 and your SI is 20, so bx plus SI will become 2020, and then increment loop to get the data from 20 to 40. Okay, so you can also decrement the SI like incrementing. Now here our bx is 2000, we are incrementing source index register, okay, by initializing it with 20, then 21, 22, 23 up to 40. So we will get the group of data from this instruction. Okay, then last one is the base relative plus index. So in base relative plus index, address is given as base register, as base index base register plus index register plus displacement. That means it is a combination of relative indirect register addressing mode, base index addressing mode and base relative addressing mode. Okay, so move CL comma BX plus SI plus 03H. So CL will get BX plus SI plus 03. Now here what will happen, this is memory location, bx is set to memory location 4000. Okay, set SI to 20 and displacement 3 is given. After adding this 3, now it means that after adding bx plus SI plus displacement 03, what memory location we will get? 4023. It means that by using this, we will directly get data from 4023 memory location. Okay. And there is fifth one, addressing mode, that I forget to told you, that implied addressing mode. Okay. So what is addressing mode? How we give the operand? So now in all this case we give something in other. Okay, so indirect addressing mode, data is given in immediate addressing mode, data is given in instruction. Then register addressing mode, data is given in register. Indirect addressing mode, data was given in the instruction. In register indirect addressing mode, address was given in register. So we give something about operand. Okay, but in implied addressing mode, you don't need to tell the operand. You don't tell the processor what is operand. We don't tell on what we working on. But still, the processor manages to do the operations because प्रोसेसर अंडरस्टैंड द वर्ड इम्प्लाइड. इम्प्लाइड मीन्स अंडरस्टूड विदाउट गिविंग ऑपरेंड. सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू मैनेज द ऑपरेशन दैट इज इट इज इम्प्लाइड. ऑपरेंड इज इम्प्लाइड लाइक STC means set the carry flag. Okay, so set the carry flag to make a carry flag 1. This instruction is built only to work on carry flag. Since it only works on carry flag, we don't need to write STC carry flag. Even if I write only STC, it is implied to rest of the answer that there is some instruction which works only on particular operand. Since they work only on particular operand, you don't need to write an operand because it is implied in instruction. And if operand is fixed or operand can be only one register, you don't need to write an operand. Another example is increment BL. It will increment BL. Okay. CL, DL. If I write only increment, it is an invalid instruction because it work on register. But STC, this increment will work on any register. Okay, so if I write only increment without writing this, it will be invalid. Okay, but if I write only STC, it works as STC is works only on carry flag, it will be a valid. Processor knows that it is work on carry flag, that is it is an implied. We don't need to write operand. Okay, then second one is CLC, that is clear the carry flag. Again, processor knows that CLC means clear the carry flag. We don't need to mention operand in this case. Okay, so this is all about the addressing modes.